So in this video, we will have a closer look at these shock mount, a boom pole, and mic stand shock mount from Röhde. These are the SM-4R, uses the standard, I believe is 3/8-inch thread on the mount there. You can also get these in a variant that uses a cold shoe or hot shoe mount, but I just wanted to have a standard microphone mount there. And I'm going to use these on my Röhde NCG4 and my NCG4 Plus. I'm actually recording into my NCG4 Plus right now. And one of these mounts are going into this overhead setup I have. And the other one is going into my A-roll setup that I have on my left here. And the reason for getting these is because my setup is attached to the wall. My overhead setup here, I have made my own homemade wall attachment or wall mount that I have my camera and my microphone on. So every time somebody in my home is actually using the doors nearby in the other room or in the hallway, I can actually hear it on the microphone because the sound just transfers straight through the wall and into the microphone. So it would be nice to be able to isolate that microphone a little bit from the wall itself. And that's where some mount like this will come in handy. And my other one, like I said, is going to my A-roll setup. I don't really use that often, but I really want to use a little bit more. And I use that microphone, NCG4 from Röhde, on a PSA1 mount connected to my desk. And my desk is also connected to the wall or mounted on the wall. Every time I actually put something on my like table, it will go straight through the PSA1 mount into the microphone. But also, again, if somebody else in my home there uses a nearby door in the living room or in the hallway, it will kind of also transfer into, or the sound will actually go into the microphone. So yeah, I've been wanting to get some of these mounts for quite some time, but I just find it hard to actually spend money on something I don't really need, but just it is a nice thing to have just to get as clean an audio as I possibly can. I got these off Amazon. It was the cheapest one I could find here in Europe. And these are, of course, made with the Rycote Lyra suspension. So I believe this will last a lifetime, so I don't have to swap out any kind of elastic bands or anything like that. So that's kind of a nice thing, even though you're probably going to pay a little bit more for this. Not really that expensive, but definitely, in my opinion, worth it to get these Rycote mounts instead of those elastic ones. You also have some cable management integrated and variable mounting, whatever that means. But I suppose you can mount the microphone either direction. On the back of the box, of course, you have some information. Like I said, it was does have a 3/8-inch, or you also have a 5/8-inch thread. I believe there's an adapter included. And of course, you can use it on a boom pole, but I just want to mount this on my rack here at home. 110 grams. You of course have your dimensions here, and suitable for the wide range of NCG microphone from Röhde, but of course you can probably use it on other microphones as well. Little Röhde branding there on the other side of the box. Bottom side here, you can see it was imported by Hyperactive Audio Technique. But like I said, I bought them off Amazon and they were sold by Amazon themselves. So I'm not really sure if these are some of the partners Amazon are working with. But anyways, let's just get into the box. And let's get a little unboxing knife here. And that's everything we have in the box. So you need to do some assembling here. You get the mount itself nicely tucked in place. So you can see that it is a variable bracket system here. So you can kind of screw in those Rycote mounts here where they suit the microphone best, which is kind of a nifty little feature there. So you can get the optimal placement of your microphone. And there's definitely plenty of screws included, 4 screws that I can count here. And you only really need one to actually mount it. And let's just get everything out of this packaging here. You also get the little Röhde branding tool here to, of course, screw those screws in place. Let's just get these Rycote brackets out of the box, or the packaging rather. So you have a mounting instructions here. You can of course see you can mount these brackets there in either of those 4 positions on the mount to accommodate for shorter microphones, or of course longer shotgun microphones. I'm going to use them on a shotgun microphone, so probably going to mount it something like this, where either of the brackets is in the furthest apart of each end of the bracket there. And then of course you have the Rycote suspension. Like said, this should just be good for life. You of course can wear them down if you change microphone often, but other than that, the springiness of this plastic here should last forever, so shouldn't really need to replace these ever. And I got 4 screws with this unit here, so definitely plenty. You only really need 1 screw to mount one of these to the base. So a little bit strange they included 4, not just 3 or something like that if you want a spare one, but definitely a nice thing. And I'm probably gonna screw them in place here, all 4 of them, so I just have a spare one. Bracket itself, there is some cable management going on here on the back. Quite nice, so you can organize the cables. Of course, tie them in here. This is some rubber going on here. All the gray on the back there, it is rubber, so you can kind of catch the cable. Of course, some rubber branding here. And yeah, you have 4 places to actually mount those Rycote brackets. And then you have the mount here itself. It comes with an adapter already installed. But of course, it is a 3/8 inch and a 5/8 inch adapter. And you can also, if you want to mount it to some kind of camera gear, you can adapt it even further to like 1/4 inch. And there's also 2 screws down here if you want to ever disassemble the bracket for whatever reason. But like I said, you can also get this with a cold shoe mount instead of this one here. But the ones here is better suited for the kind of task I want to use. But if you want to mount this on the camera itself, definitely a nice thing to just have the cold shoe adapter instead of you have to adapt this one here. It will just get pretty long. So as per recommended by the little diagram here, I'm going to mount the shotgun microphone. So I'm just going to mount these 2 Rycote brackets here, end of the bracket here, furthest apart. And let's just try and mount this first one here to my NCG4. Of course, the only difference between the NCG4 and the NCG4 Plus is the Plus is a little bit longer, I believe around 2.5 centimeters longer, because they have a built-in battery, but this one does not. On the little bracket, you can actually see it can accommodate between 19 and 22 millimeter thickness of the microphone itself. So, of course, should not be longer than that. Let's actually measure this one here. The NCG 4 Plus is exactly 22 millimeter. So it is within spec. So everything up to 22 millimeters should be fine with this one, and down to 19 millimeters. And let's just try and mount it, of course. Putting a screw here. Use the little tool included. And just screw it in place. So couldn't really be simpler. And let's just mount the second one here. So it is attached to the 2 mounting points here. That is the furthest apart. And actually lines up pretty well with the microphone here. Let's try and attach it to the bracket. As you can see here, it does fit quite well when they're furthest apart, but let's also try and actually put the little wind cover or plosive cover on here that's included with the microphone. So for this microphone, NCG4, because I use this cover, I would probably just mount it in the 3rd hole there, because it is a rather short shotgun microphone as well. Let's just try that. So yeah, I feel like this is a little bit better. Mounting it in the outer hole here, on the back side here, and in the 3rd hole here, on the front, with the NCG4. The 4 Plus, I probably will mount it on the outside there. And this fit perfectly with the wind cover as well on, or the foam cover on, so yeah. This is probably how I will mount my NCG4. So this is going to replace the standard cover, or excuse me, the standard mount that actually comes with the NCG4, and I believe pretty much all Röhde shotgun microphones. This one here doesn't have any kind of shock absorption, so of course that's why I wanted to upgrade to this one here. But the mount itself, you can see the way you attach it to your stand or arm, boom pole or whatever, is exactly the same. Only real difference is there's a little arrow on this one here, of course indicating that you can actually lift off tightening rod there to get a better position, but other than that, they are pretty much identical. And how much does this weigh with the 2 brackets attached? Let's just put it on the scale here. So 105.5 gram. That's actually a little bit lighter than the 110 grams advertised here on the box. So around 5 gram or 4.5 grams lighter, which is of course nice, especially if you're going to use this on a boom pole. It will be like 4.5 grams lighter, which not isn't really that much, but definitely it's quite nice. And the spare two screws there, I will mount these on the bracket itself just to keep them in place so I won't lose them. You can't even tie the front one deeper than this one here, but yeah, I'll still keep them attached to the mount. But I'm really looking forward to actually started using these microphones with this mount here and don't have to worry about those bumping noise like from door closing and me putting stuff on the table, especially with the one I use here with the PSA mount. So yeah, I highly recommend something like this. Doesn't really cost all that much and pretty nice to be able to eliminate as many noises in the recording process so you don't have to deal with those later. And yeah, she feels to be like pretty high quality. I can of course share some affiliate links down in the description below if you are interested. But that's pretty much it for this one. I hope to see you again in a future one. Until then, take care.